A new documentary titled Ghost Fleet highlights the dark and criminal side of the seafood industry. From shrimp to tuna, a large part of the everyday foods that we eat come at the expense of slaves forced to work on shipping vessels for years without seeing land. Take a look.
เราถูกบังคับให้ทำงานเกือบแทบจะไม่ได้เห็นแผ่นดินเลย
ถูกตี
หางกระเบียนตี
ถูกบริษัทตามล่าทั้งวันทั้งคืน
วันนั้นมีผู้หญิงมา
แกก็ถามผมอีกว่าแล้วอยากกลับบ้านไหม
So joining me now is the director of Ghost Fleet, Shannon Service, and the executive producer, Julia Ormond. Thank you so much for joining me, ladies. We were talking a little bit in the break. I was blown away by this documentary. It was something that I never even knew existed. And I sort of have to make it clear to people. We are talking about slavery. You open the documentary with a man who's going out on a Friday night, and he blacks out and wakes up in a ship that he cannot get off of for years. The ships do not return to land. Explain how it works.
Sure. So unfortunately, you know, that's an all too common scenario, especially inside Thailand, where a guy will just be out, a drug will be put in his drink, he wakes up on board a boat, and there's nothing but sea. Some of these guys have never seen the ocean before they end up on a boat, and then they don't see land again for 10 years, mm-hmm. 15 years. The way that they keep the boats at sea is through a system of motherships, these shuttle boats that bring the ice and the men and methamphetamines out to these boats and then bring the fish back.
Right.
And so this is, through that system, they can keep the fishing boats way far away from shore as they're chasing fewer and fewer fish around the world. These shuttle boats basically keep the entire slavery system and overfishing system in place.
Mm-hmm. And all the brutality that one would expect comes with slavery, the dehumanizing of these people is what they endure on these ships. But the documentary is following an activist, a woman who has taken it upon herself to save these men. And she's saved thousands so far. Tell me a little bit about her.
She's amazing. Mm-hmm. I mean, we were just talking earlier about how remarkable it is to see a woman who's putting her life at risk to go and rescue and save these men. And they're here in New York now. And we talked about the fact that as you have all this D-Day stuff, that we took them to see the Statue of Liberty. Mm-hmm. And she's one of these people who, I've worked on this issue for quite a long time now. She's one of these people who, as you have these veterans and as you have D-Day, none of those people who died in World War II died so that only a few of us could survive. They died so that all of us could be free.
Mm-hmm.
And this is someone who, Padma, her life is about going to find these men who were trapped and kind of dumped and separated from their families for years, mm-hmm. but she's also chasing down the story. So it's a story of environmental and social justice. And for me, as somebody who's worked on this issue for a long time, it's really rare that somebody like Shannon has had the ability for years to be tracking this story. What is the illegal fishing like? And so to have these men and her step up and tell us, this is the story, this is how it works,
yes.
then we can actually make that human connection,
yeah.
you were talking about seeing it,
yeah.
make the human connection with the person on the other end of the supply chain mm-hmm. who's doing the actual work. It's really easy to believe when you're shopping and buying tuna or at a restaurant, oh, this looks great, therefore it must be clean. And it's
right.
actually not. We're at the point where the oceans are dying. All of the research says that it's a few actors in the space. It's a few countries,
mm-hmm.
and it's all focused on the high seas. But we're at the point where the oceans are dying, fish stocks are not able to support us, especially as the population increases,
yeah.
and coastal fishing has died out.
Yeah.
So we have to stop, we literally have to stop fishing in the high seas. And the high seas are anywhere that is 200 miles off any country's coast,
mm-hmm.
where those fish supplies should be supporting those populations and having them thrive. Anything beyond that is high seas.
And this is where some of this illegal fishing takes place. Yes. It's no surprise that, that companies or individuals who would be willing to abuse human beings would also be abusing the planet. I want to get more into that, but I want to sort of underline some of the human stories that you tell, because the thing about these, for these men, some of them do escape these ships, and they literally swim for their lives, but they have been gone for years and years and years from their homes, and they don't have the ability to get back to where they came from. And she goes and finds them and offers them the option to come back home. But what is heartbreaking is that even when presented with that option, many of them feel like they can't. And I think there's a time, Kazem, where she allows him to make a video for his family. And he is a broken man. He's only in his 40s, and he feels like there's nothing left of his life. Can you tell me about how not only does this ordeal, you know, sort of, you can die, but even if you don't die, and I think that's why it's titled Ghost Fleet, Ghost Fleet is part of this, even if you don't die physically, these young, these men often, a part of them dies inside.
Yeah, one of the things that Tun Lin is another character who actually is really, really remarkable. He and a number of these men who Patima has helped rescue and bring back now has joined with her to go find other men like him and bring them home as part of his own healing and his own kind of going from being a ghost or being broken. His healing is in actually finding others and helping to rescue them. So it's a really remarkable story of redemption and of courage and, you know, ultimately of our humanity as we're looking, facing this, the darkness of our supply chains and the destruction of our connection to each other, right? So it's all of it. But back to Kasim, you know, he's in this crazy situation because he was forced on board, he was enslaved, he jumped ship. Many of these guys have never seen the ocean, as I said before. They haven't swum, so they'll grab a plastic jug or something, jump into the water. If they make it to land, then they're homeless. They don't speak the language. Right. They don't have a passport.
And if the company catches up with them, they end up in the company jail.
Exactly, exactly. Yeah. And so what happens is often once they do speak the language, they'll, if they're lucky, you know, they'll find an amazing woman and they'll settle down. They'll get married. So when Patima shows up and says, "Hey, you can see your family. Your family back home thinks you're dead. Do you want to go home?" They're suddenly torn between the family that they've established where they are and being able to go back. So when they can't go back, Patima and Tun Lin will take a video and go find the family, let them know that their loved one is alive, and try to reconnect them. And that's the scene, that anguish of having to choose between the life you've created and the one you left behind.
So in watching this, 5 minutes into it, I thought, how do I make sure I don't contribute to this, right? How do I ensure that I'm not eating fish from, you know, what are the companies supporting this? I had so many questions. Tell me, how do we make a difference?
So that's been my drive, really, since being working with the UN as a goodwill ambassador since 2007, bringing back footage to them of boys who did exactly that, jumped ship, floated on a barrel for 2 days a night. My constant question is, am I actually purchasing this fish? So now what we have is we have the ability through transparency laws, through satellite technology, through GPS tracking, we now know where the vessels are and where they're fishing. And we have a bit of a way to go to get the consumer platforms up and running, but you can go to Monterey Bay Aquarium. If people want to know more, we would love people to text to 52886, the word ghost. So text 52886 ghost, or go to the Ghost Fleet website and then join up and learn more and support us in a journey of coming together in partnership. We have to make it really easy for the consumer. And that means all of that work and everybody working together, and there's huge amount of progress. All of that work means that we actually do have the capability to stop it. We actually do, we have to be able to stop fishing on the high seas, stop subsidizing stuff that doesn't work to feed a few of us. And It really is possible. Yeah. I think that's the big message to get across.
And one thing, it sounds really simple, but just asking where your fish comes from, it's that simple. Because as you were saying before, we know so much about the rest of our food. We know that this beef is grass-fed, that his name was Jack, that he was massaged every day, he drinks beer. You know, we know everything about him, literally.
True.
Right? Which is wonderful.
Yeah.
But fish just shows up. It's like, it's guiltless, it's blameless. Sometimes the fish you're eating isn't even the fish that you think you're eating. I mean, it's a complete mess.
It's super important to understand, however much we want to shun this and say it's the other side of the world, 25% of our fish is coming from illegal fishing. Mm. And that 25% is fished by taking everything out of the ocean. So for that one fish that you eat, there's probably five that were killed and dumped because they didn't meet certain standards. Transparency and all of the technology and tracing enables us to separate the good actor in the space from the bad actor in the space. Mm-hmm. It's government action, it's corporate action, and it's being able to say, I will purchase from this responsible brand, and I will support action that says we stop in the high seas.
Well, I went to the website because that's what you suggested in the documentary, and there's a lot of great information out there. Ghost Fleet, thank you very much, ladies. Ghost Fleet is available in select theaters tomorrow. That is June 7th. Shannon Service, Julia Ormond, thank you so much. It's an incredible movie.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.